Hey everyone, welcome to our first lesson with Inventor. Inventor is a CAD program, which stands for Computer Aided Design. Okay, and what this screen is, this is the screen that you'll first see when you open it up. On the left-hand side are some options. You can choose to open up a new file, you can choose to open up a file that you've created previously, or you can open up a project. Down below, any files that you have been working with recently will show up in a list right here. So for today, let's go ahead and open up a new file. And now we have some options. Whenever you're first starting a project, you're going to use standard IPT. This is like the standard, the basic screen layout. So I'm going to go ahead and click that and then click create down here. And of course, this is a huge program that we have on our computers, so it always does take a minute to load. So don't get impatient or try to click things twice. Just give it a second and it will work. All right. Here we go. Okay, so this is what the blank screen will look like. This is a totally blank canvas for us. On the left-hand side, this is called the browser bar. And anything that you do, any little pieces that you add, will show up as in a list here as a step. And you can always click on it and go back to it. I'll show you more about this later. At the top here, this is called the ribbon, the tool ribbon. This is where basically all your tools are. So when you're going to create something like making it 3D, or if you're going to be adding little embellishments like a coil or a shell or camphor, any of those things, this is the where you'll go to do that. So that's called the ribbon. Alright, this over here on the right hand side, this is kind of our navigation. This allows you to kind of move around in the screen and look at things from different angles. So let's go ahead and create something. The first thing you're going to want to do is click over here where it says create 2D sketch. Now it shows up here, you can kind of see there's three different planes intersecting here. We've got our X plane, our Y plane, and our Z plane. We're going to go ahead and just choose this one. Notice how when I have my mouse just over it, it turns white. Once it's white like that, I'm going to click, and it kind of rotates on me, so now I'm looking at it straight on. Alright, so now I'm going to go over here and choose to create a rectangle. You notice that some of the tools have changed now. These are all tools for working in a 2D sketch. So, rectangle, and I'm just going to click, and then move my mouse, and then click again. And now I have my rectangle. Let's say this is exactly how I want it to be, so I'm going to leave it just like that, and I'm going to click up here, finish sketch. That means I'm done with my 2D sketch, and now I want it to become 3D. The way we make it 3D is to use this tool called extrude. I'm going to go ahead and click on extrude, and see how it automatically selected my box. I only had one box to choose from, so it just automatically chose that one. Now I can decide how far out I want it to stick. Right now it's at 1 inch. I could say 0.5 and it would be 0.5 inches. I could do 0.6 and it would be 0.6. I'll just leave it there. So whatever you want it to be. And then I'm just going to click OK. Alright, now I have my box. And over here you'll notice our navigation has changed a little. If I want to look at it directly from the front, it'll turn, and now I'm looking just from the front. If I want to look at the top, I'm looking at just from the top. If I want to look at it from the right side, now I'm looking at it right from the right side. Gonna flip it around a little. If I want to go back to 3D, there's a little house over here. That's called the home button. I click on that, and it brings me back home. Okay. Now let's say I want to move it around a little bit. I can use my hand tool and shift it over to way over to one side of the screen or the other. Okay. And I'll click on it to get off of it. I can use this button. It says zoom, zoom all. If I just click on it, it automatically kind of centers it for me, which is great. I can now use my scroll on my mouse to kind of zoom out far away. And then as soon as I can move my hand, I can use the hand to move it around some more. And if I click on this magnifying glass, it'll bring me right back to home. Okay, so this concludes the introduction lesson to Inventor.